Hi, this is Damien from Platform 9, here to talk about getting started with Private Cloud Director Community Edition. I'll cover what Community Edition is, how to deploy it and its hypervisor hosts, how to create virtual machines with some networking along the way. Community Edition is a full-featured version of Private Cloud Director that's installable on a VM or server and is free forever with community support at our Platform 9 subreddit. Everything in this video is also covered in our documentation at platform9.com/docs. Let's get started with the install. Here I'm going to SSH into my CE host and run the curl command to begin the install. This process normally takes about 45 minutes, but I've sped it up to save some time. Be sure to copy the credentials that are created after the installation to a safe place. These can be changed later if you desire. Since I don't have a DNS server on this network, I'll need to add some custom DNS entries to my host file that allows the fully qualified domain name for the CE install to resolve to its IP address. Then, using a browser from that same machine, I go to the Community Edition URL, where I can log in using local credentials, and I enter the credentials that I got from the install process. The first step is to create a cluster blueprint. This defines how the hypervisor hosts in the cluster will be configured. We'll leave most of the defaults in place, except to choose a VLAN range for my virtual machines, and to define a host networking configuration. The machine I'm using for the hypervisor host only has one Ethernet interface, so I will allow all cluster traffic types over that interface. Next, I need to add an NFS storage volume type. Without this, my virtual machines would only be ephemeral and stored on the hypervisor host. I'll leave the rest of the settings as the default and save the blueprint. Then, I go to Cluster Hosts and then Add a New Host. The process for doing so is outlined here, but first I need to make some configuration changes on the host. So after SSHing into my hypervisor host, I will add the DNS entries in the host file and then trust the self-signed certificate from the Community Edition host. Then I can follow the instructions from the user interface. This process configures the hypervisor host to be used in the correct region and tenant and installs any necessary packages. After that process finishes, the host will show up in the UI as unauthorized, which means that I need to assign roles to it. I'll tell it which network configuration to use, that I want it to be a hypervisor, that it should store my operating system images, and that it should use the NFS storage for persistent VMs. The host will begin converging to that configuration I just applied. From here, I want to add an operating system image to my image library. Since this is the first time I'm doing this, I need to install the Private Cloud Director CLI client first. Then I need to copy and paste the environment variables from the user interface into a file. I make sure to use the password that was given to me, then I save and exit and use the source command to activate those environment variables in my terminal. Then I can use the CLI to upload a Ubuntu image that I downloaded from the internet before. I'm going to use the insecure flag due to that self-signed certificate. I'll choose the bare container format, the qcow2 disk format. I'll set it as public, meaning other tenants that I create in Community Edition can see the image, and leave it unprotected, meaning that it can be deleted without a confirmation. The progress flag shows me the progress of the upload, and then I tell it the file name of the image and what I want that file to be called in the UI. Now I can go back to the user interface and see that the image is ready and active. Now before I start creating networks, I want to make sure that I've got the security group configuration that I want. The default security group allows all outbound traffic, but does not allow inbound traffic. So I previously created an all traffic group that allows all types of inbound and outbound traffic for the purposes of this demo. Now I want to start creating some networks for my virtual machines. I'm going to create a virtual network first, including its subnet, with the address range and gateway I want to use, and I'll leave DHCP enabled. Now I can create a new VM using that Ubuntu image. I'll select the network, name it, change the password using cloud init, and assign a network security group. After that VM is deployed and active, I can log into that VM with a web console using the password I chose with cloud init. I see that an IP address on the virtual network has been assigned, but I can't ping google.com because there's no way for the network traffic to get there. So what I will need is a physical network. I create that network, use the network label I chose in the cluster blueprint, choose a flat network because this is my external network, and then create the subnet. Now I could either assign the VM to this physical network, or I can use a virtual router to connect the virtual and physical networks together. I'm going to go ahead and choose the latter. So after creating the router and assigning that external network, I'll then have to add the virtual network interface. Now in my VM, I can ping google.com. So let's deploy a VM on the physical network to validate that it can both ping Google and the VM on the virtual network. Hey, looks like everything is working great. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope this has been helpful.